he's telling God, he said, I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou givest me out of the world. Ephesians 3, 14 to 15 says, for this cause I bow my knees unto the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family in heaven and on earth is named. Jesus Christ is the family name. Colossians 3, 17 says, and whatsoever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So if the baptism you are baptizing now, you are baptizing in the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost. Have you obeyed Colossians 3, 17? No. Colossians 3, 17 says, in whatever you do, in deeds and in words. So that was why when I was there yesterday, I was still hearing this man of God by saying, okay, after prayer, I said, so in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, saying God, not again. Very far from the revelation. He said, whatever you do, if you are blessing food, before now, when I was a Catholic, that was how I pray. Truly, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. What is the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost? If you are being oppressed by witches and wizards, shall Father, they will beat you the more. Son, they will even kill you before you realize what you're saying. Praise the Lord. It's the truth. Praise the Lord. But people are so, two spirits in the church, spirit of truth and spirit of error. Error has taken over so many things. So what I'm preaching now, because people are so sold to error, it is difficult for some people to believe it. My sister here, the husband, when he came, I asked the husband, he said he was baptized in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And he's from Jamaica. Praise the Lord. Many people know the truth already. But why is it that so many people don't know it? And some people know it, they just read it, they see it, but they refuse to accept it. Why? The spirit of error has blinded them, so they will not be saved. And if you have the Holy Ghost, the duty of the Holy Ghost is to reveal the truth of the word to you. And in revealing the truth of the word to you, the Holy Ghost will cause you to obey the word of God. Obedience to the word of God. Praise the Lord. Many people will perish because they refuse to obey the word of God. Colossians 3 says, and whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God and the Father by Him. Not in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen. No, it's wrong. Hebrews 1:4 says, being made so much better than the angels, as he had been inheritance, as he had by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. Through inheritance, Jesus Christ obtained an excellent name, the Father's name. Praise the Lord. Acts 4, 12 says, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is no other name, under heaven and given among men whereby we must be saved. No other name for salvation. So if you are baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, I categorically tell you that your sins are not remitted according to the Bible. He said salvation is in a name. He said in no other name, no other name are we saved but in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Bible said, my people, they perish because of lack of knowledge. He said, neither is there salvation in any other name, for there is no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. What is that name? Jesus Christ. That is the name of the Father, that is the name of the Son, that is the name of the Holy Ghost. Galatians 3:27 says, for as many of you as have been baptized unto Christ have put on Christ. How are you baptized unto Christ? How are you baptized unto Christ? By tying with Christ, buried with Christ, and risen with Christ. Praise the Lord. We're talking about remission of sins. Romans 6:3:25, 3-5 says, know ye not that so many of us, as we are baptized into Jesus Christ, we are baptized into his death through his name. What is the importance of this name? Why am I so stressing this name? Why am I stressing it so much? Why is it so important? One, for the remission of your sins. If your sins are not remitted, you can't stand before God. Praise the Lord. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And secondly, the accuser of brethren is accusing us day and night. Who is the accuser of brethren? Satan. And the Bible says we overcame Satan by that blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. How do we overcome him? It's not by declaring Satan, blood of Jesus Christ against you. Be paralyzed by blood. No. Satan knows better. Look at it by revelation. By revelation, Abel knew that something happened that required blood. That was why he had to sacrifice an animal. And Cain did not know that thing. And his sacrifice was not accepted. But even when God told him to go and sacrifice an animal to what his brother did, he refused because he had a sinful nature in him. A serpent's nature. He rejected it. Praise the Lord. By revelation, this you will know that for your sins to be remitted, you have to be baptized correctly. Now, baptism is for the remission of your sins, and baptism is also for you to overcome Satan. There is an overcoming power that comes upon you when you are baptized. And when you are baptized, now you can stand and tell Satan, I am already delivered. You tell Satan, I want you to pray this prayer. If you think I am lying, if you have already been baptized, if there is a demon tormenting you, just tell Satan, I am dead in Christ. I am buried in Christ. I am risen in Christ. I am hid in Christ as Christ is hid in God. I am one with Christ as Christ is one with God. I am married to my Lord Jesus Christ. Satan, I command you, get out of my life. I invoke the blood of Jesus Christ against you. I tell you, as you continue to pray this prayer, Satan will one day come, throw his load and run away from you. Because there is power in that blood. We overcome Satan by the blood of the Lamb. We must know who we are. Praise the Lord. That overcoming power comes through water baptism. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Immediately you are baptized, your sins are washed away. Your sins are washed away. Praise the Lord. A new nature comes upon you now. A new nature comes upon you now. So we are talking about remission of sin. Our sins have to be remitted properly so that we can stand before God as if we have never sinned. If you have done baptism in the name, in that title, Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, I reiterate it, go and do the right thing. Baptism is in a name. And that name is not title, not Father, not Son, not Holy Ghost. It is the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Why? The name Jesus Christ is a family name. It is the name that God is bearing in heaven. It is the name that he gave his Son for redemption. And it is the name that the Holy Ghost came to this earth with. Praise the Lord. Bow down your head and talk to God. Father, we thank you.